Hi guys! So today I'm going to be wear testing a bunch of new Maybelline products, mainly the brand new Superstay Foundation Stick. If you haven't seen already, Maybelline also has a liquid version of the Superstay 24 Hour Foundation, which is pretty bomb. I have a wear test review for that as well when it released a couple months back. I'll link it off in the cards and down below if you guys want to check it out and you can see how they compare. Of course, I'll probably reference that towards the end of the video when I give you guys my thoughts, but first we're going to do our application clip. Wear this for a bunch of hours. And most of you guys already know how this goes. So if you're new here, feel free to subscribe. It's free and you guys can join the fam. I'm always reviewing stuff and Maybelline is one of my favorite brands. So I purchased all of these on Amazon myself. I picked three shades and as you can see, I'm holding four. Amazon, I love you, but we need to talk. The one thing I hate about Amazon is that they cannot package makeup purchase for crap. Let me show you guys my recent CoverGirl, their new foundation, ordered from Amazon. That's how it came. Literally. One foundation out of three shades was bubble wrapped. The other two was thrown in the box. And as far as these go, two of them were wrapped together in bubble wrap. The other two were just thrown out. And again, I only ordered three. I double checked. They gave me two of the same shade. So someone just doesn't care. I also will be testing the brand new Master Blur Sticks. I've tested an illuminating stick in the same packaging before. I'll also link that off. And I think these are brand new. So there's one that's transparent and the other one is tinted. I picked medium tan. There was medium tan and light medium. Let's hope I didn't get that wrong. I'm sure a lot of you have seen this already, but I wanted to try it out for myself. This is the new Lemonade palette. Pretty eyeshadows. I'll probably just wear this today because I wanted to give it a go. And then they released some new lipstick shades. These are shine finishes. And I picked up Baddest Beige and Chocolate Lust. I don't know what shades to pick. I just picked those two. They looked pretty good and up my alley. But look at this. Someone want to explain how this is how it came. I didn't do anything to it. Makes any sense. While the other one came butt naked. Huh? Luckily, the eyeshadow palette was bubble wrapped itself. But again, that left like half the products just rolling around the box. So Maybelline, you need to talk to your peeps at Amazon. As far as the Face Studio Master Blur Sticks go, we're gonna apply this first and I'm gonna do like one on each side. I usually do half of my face when there's one primer, but we got two right now. So I'm gonna try to leave some sections undone. We'll see how that goes. I only got one face, guys. I can only do so much. So these retail for $7.99. This is how much product you get. Basically this amount in the packaging. Wind that back down. As you can see, she has eyelash extensions and, you know, microbladed brows. That's all we got on our face right now. The rest of it is looking pretty good lately. I have a lot of blackheads. I'm getting a facial tomorrow, so those will get extracted, but I do have a lot of blackheads right now over here. I can feel them. They're really tiny, but my pores be getting clogged. So I'm gonna put this. Ooh, it glides very nicely. I'm gonna put this around my nose. Oh, this feels really good. A little bit under the under eye. And now everything just kind of glides there compared to like getting stuck a little bit. There's really no friction. That was nice. And I'll put some clear over here. And then a little chinny chin chin. All right, as much as I want to put like one on one side and one on the other, I'm going to try to just mix both on one side because I want to see what it looks like without primer. So we're going to put the tinted, ooh, yeah, the tinted one's a little dark. Just in the contour spots. I haven't really used a tinted primer much. And this is like kind of orangey. In this area, do a little chinny chin chin. Okay, well, I'm glad I didn't put that on my nose because it looks a little crazy. I like the translucent one a lot better already. Now we have our not primed side and our prime side over here. This looks crazy. For the three shades that I picked out for my face, one was for contouring, which was Mocha. It's a little bit darker, as you can see. I think this possibly is the darkest shade, actually, out of all of the shades. There's not as many shades in the stick foundation as the liquid foundation, which is a little sad, but these are supposed to be multi-use sticks as advertised. They're supposed to be good for highlighting, contouring, and using as a foundation. I usually wear shade 220 in the liquid foundation, which is natural beige. It follows a little rule I have about natural beige because 90% of the time, if there is a natural beige, it most likely will fit me. So of course I picked up 220 natural beige. But just in case I'm a little tanner, I picked up a shade right after that, which is 312 golden. And these are both yellow undertone shades. We're gonna find out right now. Oh my, this is all that comes in it. I thought it'd be this much. Uh-huh. Well, that's what we have on one side. And the other side, we have an applicator, which is like a squishy sponge. This feels identical to the sponge that Maybelline sells for application. If you go check out my liquid foundation review, I have that sponge in that video as well. And I do like that sponge a lot. It's actually more curved in that video than this, but it's the same texture. I don't like the fact that this is not removable. It doesn't seem like it twists off at all. So this could be kind of unhygienic, but I guess for on-the-go touch-ups, it's there. That's natural beige, and that looks pretty darn good already. And that's gold. Oh, that's gold. And I used a little applicator to get that off. Blend it in. I really do not like applicators dry, but I wouldn't feel good about wetting it just because I feel like mold would grow underneath it since it doesn't, you know, it's not removable. So we're gonna just continue with natural beige. So I don't know about you guys, but stick foundations always feel a little heavier and a little drier than their liquid counterparts. I'm not saying that's specifically the case right now. This one is definitely creamy. It glides on the skin very well. I find that the Anastasia Beverly Hills stick foundation, which is usually what like registers in my mind, that and the Tarte stick foundation, this is just as creamy as the Tarte one, but the Anastasia one is way more dry than this. So I like how like it just glides with ease onto the face. I think that's a match, and I appreciate that they at least made this shade. Though they could have made more shades, but at least they kept the shade the same, because I know in some lines like 220 is not the same in every single product, but Maybelline usually keeps that consistent. So I've worn 220 in their Fit Me foundation, this foundation. I've been a 220 girl almost consistently throughout the years. Very high medium coverage. Definitely looks like I'm wearing foundation. And then we have the prime side that looks crazy. So we're gonna deal with that right now. Oh, I just put the top on the wrong side and I squished it. I don't like this double sided thing. It's not meant for people like me. Now my foundation's all jacked up. Okay. Now I just have a lot of foundation on my face. Freaking A. Mm-hmm. I mean, that's obviously user error, but still, I grabbed the top and then I smushed it. Well, I'm glad it covers up the primer, because that definitely had me scared for a moment. This side already looks smoother than this side just off of application. It has more of like an even, flawless finish. It's concealing any little blackheads I have a little better. So currently the primer is worth it. And I also feel like it blended way easier as well. So I kind of like that combination a lot. So now that we've smushed the foundation, let's contour our face. Tap this in because swiping never gets me anywhere. This shade is very warm and I just want to do a little bit. I'm not going to do too much, I think. We're not going to do the rest of the face. I'm not trying to look like I'm having a bronzer helmet moment. So we are just going to leave it at this. Let's see the finish, shall we? When I tell you guys that my face is like super baby bottom smooth on this side and kind of teenage hormonal mountain climby on this side, being 100%. So the primer is saving me right now, at least on half my face. So we'll just, you know, walk in with my hair covering the other side or something. I'm still so upset about this. Like, no flashback to report in pictures. I'm currently still looking okay. I really don't want this to oxidize on me, because I mean, my chest is out right now, so you guys have to understand this is so pale, but the rest of my body is like good to this face. So, you know, maybe I have to wear a different shirt out or something, or actually wear the shirt out and get some sun finally. As far as any claims go, it claims to be a cream to matte foundation, so it is definitely setting into like a healthy matte finish. There's a little shine on my cheeks, but for the most part, everything is setting to a very similar finish to the liquid foundation, and it claims to be full coverage. The coverage is comparable to the liquid foundation, a very high medium to almost full, so that I like. To the touch, it has a very velvet matte finish, so I don't think I'm gonna powder my whole face. I'm gonna apply my cheek products per usual, finish up my makeup, give you guys a few clips of that, a starting point picture, and I'll see you guys at the end of the day. We are back. It's been 10 hours and we're gonna talk about this face right now. I just took the pictures, so I'm gonna put them up on the screen. And as you can see, it looks pretty good with a few things to note. Anytime I come this close with like this type of shirt, I'm like, I'm not naked, guys, like, for show. You guys just saw my shirt, so we're good. Now that we're all up close, you can see I'm so shiny right here. But that's normal. Oily T-zone girl over here, you know. So my usual oily spots, even though they have under eye, you know, powder on it, is definitely oily. And it is on the higher end of shiny as far as what I would like to see right now. My forehead isn't too bad. The forehead actually feels pretty matte compared to my nose. My nose is just like wet. 100% this side of my face is still way better looking than the other side. So I do recommend these primers. I don't think I have the right shade of primer, but it didn't really seem to matter after the foundation was on top of it because of the coverage of the foundation. But the medium tan is a little, you know, tan. After 10 hours of wearing this foundation, I can confidently say these are the following things I like about it. I love the application. The application is very creamy. It blends very well with a sponge. I like that. I love it on top of the primer. The coverage is great, and it would just be good for those who like a good coverage drugstore foundation. The price is reasonable, but I think there are more cons currently for this than the liquid foundation. I do prefer the liquid foundation over this. No doubt about it. Just because, one, I'm a liquid foundation type of girl. That's personal preference. But two, I personally think this formula, even though they're probably obviously similar, this is just better for my skin type. This foundation, I saw the little chart on Amazon. It says it's a 24-hour wear foundation. It's good for normal to oily skin. I have oily skin, and you know, it says it's full coverage. Cream is very heavy on oily skin, and I have found cream foundations in the past that I loved. Maybelline, You and Me used to rock with the little cream foundation in the pan. It was called like the Dream Cover or something like that. I had an old review on it. I forget, but it was discontinued back in the day. That stuff was amazing, and that was like one of the best creams ever for my oily skin. But this one is a little heavy for summertime. I think in the winter, I could totally rock with this. This is so quick, easy, on the go. I do like another stick foundation, which is by Makeup Forever. I love their HD Liquid and their HD Stick. That, I actually like the stick better than the liquid. This is not the case as far as Maybelline goes. It's not a bad one, but I don't think you need both. And I think if you had normal to combination skin, you'd like this way better. But if you're oily, it definitely starts to feel heavy after a while. If you just prefer something that you don't need to like pump out or worry about, then go with the stick, sure. But there's only 10 shades, and to me that's a big con. There's 16 shades in the liquid, 10 shades in the sticks. And it's just so spread out. I showed you guys the next shade up is like completely off. So it's not even like a mixing situation. Using this for contouring, it's not bad, but I don't think the tones are perfect for my contour, so I probably won't be using the Mocha shade to contour again, because I could get a better match from a concealer or just a powder in general. It's not bad, but just not perfect and nothing worth singing praises to. For sure, all the praises go to the primer in this video. And I do really like the Lemonade palette as well. I'm wearing it on my eyes. That's just a little side note. It's very, very nice and creamy and pigmented. And generally, I love the packaging. This was a good find. If you guys want to see me do a video with that, then give this video a thumbs up. I will just try to put a poll somewhere. If you follow me on IG, maybe I'll do it there. If you don't, you should follow me on IG. It's just really hard to kind of pull things on here compared to there. Lipstick wise, I am wearing the Chocolate Lust lipstick. I gave you guys swatches earlier for both shades. The formula for these are very comfortable, very creamy, great for summer where you want like pigment, because you know you want some color on your lip, but you want that like gloss feel. This is a really great combination of those two things. I don't care for the blender on the other side of this. I'd rather pay like the $7 and just get the full sponge from Maybelline. It's a good sponge. I just don't like the combination of things. L'Oreal also came out with a infallible stick foundation, and I ordered it as well. I'll be testing that next, and that is arriving tomorrow, actually. L'Oreal's kind of known to have more like matter formulas naturally, so we'll see how they go with the stick as well. Though I don't understand the concept of releasing the stick foundations right now. Maybe for travel reasons, but it's just really heavy for summertime, guys. Like this is more like an August, September, or fall release in my opinion, but who am I to say? So no stamp of approval from me today. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Give it a thumbs up if you did. Comment if you are picking up this foundation. Share this video with your friends if you liked it that much. And yeah, thank you guys as always for watching. Please comment, rate, and subscribe, and I will see you guys in a later video.